One health means different things to different people. I suppose classically, one health is the bringing together of animals, humans, and the environment in the consideration of how disease spreads and is maintained within an ecosystem. So it's bringing the three elements together. It's very much how we take an approach that does look at the ecosystem as a whole rather than just individual elements. One of the really important things, I think, is that even for the One Health approach is a kind of modern way of thinking, we have to be prepared to learn from our history, successes and failures, and looking around us here in the bone room, we see quite a lot of history. But there's no doubt there are definitely lessons to be learned. You know, there are only two diseases that have been eliminated from the planet. One is smallpox and the other is rinderpest or cattle plague. You know, and they may not have called it One Health at the time, but there's no way that those would have been controlled and eliminated in the way that they have been, or eradicated, had it not been for effectively a One Health approach. So it's the overarching approach, I think, that really brings One Health, brings the benefits of One Health to the fore. Working in One Health is really important because unless you put those different bits of the jigsaw together, you really don't have a full solution. What's really interesting, actually, is if you take antimicrobial resistance as an example, you know, it almost doesn't matter whether the drugs that we use are being used in humans or in animals. That usage will cause there to be resistance. That's just a fact of life. But if you don't consider the whole, then you don't think about it in terms of, well, actually, what is the driver? And what you find is that although, yes, in the developed world we have issues with resistance, the biggest drivers of the spread of antimicrobial resistance is actually poverty and therefore sanitation. And so you've done all this amazing work on sequencing the genomes of the bugs that are affecting humans, but actually if you don't have clean water, if you don't handle waste appropriately, it really doesn't matter what you do at the end of the day. We might have the drugs, we might have the vaccines, we might have the bed nets, we might have the condoms, but if you don't then use those appropriately, you know, whatever it might be, do you use the bed nets? Do you practice safe sex? Do you take the drugs according to the correct schedule? Then we're never going to get a proper solution. There's a very simple answer to moving things forward, and it's education. 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 But you'd expect me to say that, right? I mean, education, it's all its manifestations. I don't necessarily mean, you know, formal courses. I mean, I think, you know, the sort of promotional stuff that you're doing here, taking messages into schools, ensuring that we do engage when we're asked questions. You know, if the press are there to ask a question, you better step up and answer it because somebody else less well qualified might well do it instead. So we have a responsibility to step up and communicate whenever we're given the opportunity, however awkward I might feel on the day.